Good morning, good afternoon. Today I am going to describe the Cisco Nexus 7000 series switches, all about its hardware architecture, its device installation and administration features. So the objective of this training is to describe how Cisco Nexus 7000 series looks like. What are their supervisor modules, input-output modules, fabric modules, how the VOQ works, how the packet flows across your fabric, right? How we can size our Cisco Nexus 7000 series switches, right? Now, so to talk about Cisco Nexus 7000 series chassis, so there are three types of chassis, Cisco 7009, Nexus 7010 and Nexus 7018, right? Now Cisco has also have launched 7004. So this is the latest one which Cisco has also launched in the Nexus 7K series. So if you talk about Cisco 7009, 7010 and 7018, 9 stands for this number of slot. So 7009 has a 9 slot chassis, 7010 has a 10 slot chassis, and 7018 has a 18 slot chassis, right? So if you bifurcate, so these 9 slot chassis can come up with 7 slot input output module and two slot of supervisor, 8 slot of input output module, 2 slot of supervisor, 16 slot of input output module and 2 slot of supervisor module. The 7009 has a 14 RU, it is 21 RU, and 7018 is a 25 RU, and this 7018 is having a very big chassis. The direction of the airflow of each module depends, right? So for 7009, the airflow is from side to side, 700 front to back, and from 7018 side to side. The port density is also mentioned here, right? The system performance and the bandwidth slot per 1 gig slot, or you know, if you install the fabric module generation 1, it can give approximately 230 Gbps of bandwidth per slot. And if you talk about the fabric module generation 2, it will provide the 550 Gbps system throughput. So we'll talk about all these things later. So let's talk about the 7009 chassis. The 7009 chassis looks like this one. It's mentioned in the PPT, right? It is having a 7 slots. So these are the 7 slots. The supervisor module installed on slot 1 and 2, right? It has a summary LED which talks about your hardware performance. The fabric modules are installed here. So these are the 5 fabric modules you can install here. If you see the rear faces, you will see there is a fan tray, right? And there is a 2 power supply, and each power supply will have a 2 power cord, which you can connect it to 2 different grid. Now, the 7010 chassis, it's a 10 slot chassis. On the top, there will be a cable manager from all the ports. If you spread a cable, you can properly tag it, manage it. Right, it is having a 10 slot chassis. Out of 10 slot, you have a 2 slot of supervisor. Supervisor are there in slot number 5 or 6. Rest all from slot number 1 to 4 and 7 to 10 are input output modules. The air of the direction of the airflow goes here, right? This is your air exhaust. And in 7010, there are 2 types of fan tray. One is system fan tray and another one is fabric fan tray. So system fan tray is a fan tray which cools down all about your system. I mean, the system fan tray cools your system, whereas a fabric fan tray is specifically designed for cooling of your fabric module. So these are all 5 fabric modules. They are installed. Okay. And this is the 3 power supply, and each power supply will have a 2 power cord. Now let's talk about 7018 chassis. 7018 chassis, as we say, it's an 18 slot chassis, out of which 16 slot is for input output module and 2 slot is for supervisor. Supervisor are there in a slot number 9 and 10, right? Air intake is from here. If you see the rear picture, there is only one type of fan tray, which is system fan tray, which is applicable for cooling to both system and a fabric, module. These are all the five fabric modules which act as a backplane. The fabric modules are placed in a vertical direction, and there are four power supply, and each power supply will have a two core. Okay, now let's talk about the supervisor module. Now, if you talk about the supervisor module, there are three types of supervisor module: SUP 1, SUP 2E, 2, and SUP 2E. So there are three types of supervisor module. This is a picture of a supervisor module 1, right, which is having a beacons, which is having a console port, aux port, management port for your outer band management. This is for your flash, right? This is for your USB, and this is for your chassis management processor. This chassis management processor has a dedicated CPU and a dedicated RAM. This is also a redundant, it is used to provide the redundancy to the out of band management. What if your OB management goes down? You can log in via CMP, because it has a separate IP address, it has a separate CPU, it has a separate RAM. So you can log in if your supervisor got hang, or if your supervisor has some problem, you are not able to log in via management Ethernet. You can log in very well via CMP Ethernet, right? And you can do all the functions like reboot, reload, software upgrade, everything from the CMP Ethernet. The CMP Ethernet is only applicable in Nexus 7K SUP 1. It has a 8 GB of RAM, right? 2 GB of flash memory, right? If you talk about where it is placed, so 7009, it can be placed on slot 1 and 2. 7010, it can be placed on slot 5 and 6. And 7018, it can be placed on slot 9 and 10. Now, if you talk about SUP 2 and SUP 2E, SUP 2 and SUP 2E are most advanced versions of the Nexus supervisor module. The Nexus SUP 2 has a one quad core, whereas Nexus SUP 2E has a two quad core. And most important thing is that it has a 12 gig of memory, and it has a 32 gig of memory, and there is no CMP module available. So CMP module support is having it is only present on supervisor 1 only, and all other like beacons, console port, management port, right, USB port, USB flash, everything, reset button, everything, it's same like SUP 1. Now, how to identify Nexus 700 product, right? So let's suppose we have this model, right? Model number. How you can verify that, which is this model number describes what? So N7K Nexus 7000 series, right? It's a chassis number. C is for chassis, so this is your chassis based module. It's for 7010, model number of your Nexus supervisor. This is your fabric, FAB stands for fabric module, and this is your generation number. Now this fab can be replaced with fab, fan, or S, right? So depends upon what is there. Instead of fab, you can use it. Now if you talk about any number of line card, so it is your Nexus 7K family, right? Family name and series ID. This is your M1 line card having a 32 port. X stands for 10 gig port, right? And this is your series of fabric, right? So this model number describes that I am using M1 module of 32 port and for 10 gig. So each port is having a 10 gig port, right? So this is how we can identify any Nexus 7K product based on its module number. Now, so there are two types of 10 gigabit rate modes. One is shared mode and another one is dedicated mode. The shared mode mostly, configurable on port groups. So there are two types of line cards. One type of line card, there is no grouping. Another type of LAN card, there is a grouping of 2 ports, 4 ports, 6 ports, 8 ports, and 12 ports. So all those LAN cards which are having a grouping enabled, there you can configure a rate mode, which we can configure as a shared mode or a dedicated mode. Shared mode is by default, dedicated mode you can configure it. So let's suppose if you have a LAN card which is supporting two groups, grouping of 4 groups. So one will be even, another one will be the odd, right? So, and for these groups, if you configure a rate mode like shared mode, even though each port has a 10 gig capability, but because you configured a shared mode, their combined bandwidth will be 10 gig only. Right? Now, if you configure a particular group in a dedicated mode, what will happen? REST 3 will be down. The first member of the group will only provide a 10 gig. Right? So three other interfaces in a port group are disabled. Right? So this shared mode and dedicated mode can only be configured on those line cards where they support grouping. And the grouping may be of 2-port, 4-port, 6-port, 12-port. I mean, it depends upon which type of grouping. While purchasing your line card, you should refer to the Cisco data sheet, line card data sheet, where you can find that this line card supports grouping or this line card doesn't support grouping.